Our boy Deku. What if Deku was abandoned part two? So, if this does get, like, I put out the first part within a couple of hours, it was in the hundreds. Cool. But this does pretty good, whatever, I'm gonna hit, we gonna hit some more, but, cause I'm gonna record two parts right now. Anyways, we pretty much left off with Deku, he got a job really early. And he was doing some things. Your boy Deku was basically forced to. He was like, "All right, look, little nigga, go outside and play with some people." Like, we could say he's like 9 or something. We could say he's like 9 or like dumb young, okay? And with that being said, Deku's gonna be like forced to go outside and go to a party. This kid's actually a lot stronger than his. He's actually a lot stronger than his stronger than a kid should be, and obviously stronger than his current self. He's been doing a lot of training, physical training of all calibers, and working out, and actually somehow eating a very balanced diet due to the money. Due to the money, he was able to max out his diet, eating basically raw vegetables and raw fruits for the most part, while consistently working out and drinking hella water. And he'll occasionally have his vegan dessert or some shit like that. But like, your boy, he is hustling hard for a 9-year-old. So he has some hands, okay? And so with that being said, we got your boy, he's doing his thing, and now he's at the park mad. Got beer. Then he see a blonde chick, a blonde female with some golden eyes, looking at a bird. No, she's crying. Deku walks up on this motherfucker and like, "Bro, stop being a bitch." And what he wanted to say, but he's like, nah, hold up. She didn't do nothing to me." He has like a very bad flashback of what happened a couple years back, when he was basically dipped off. And or like his parents dipped off, so we could say what since he's 9, maybe like 3 years passed. Yeah, 3 years math, quick math. So he's talking to this female. She turns around. He's like, "What is wrong with you, female?" And then she starts telling, "My parents are saying I'm weird," and she's basically crying because she's got like a blood quirk. This and that. This and that. And he was like, "How does it work?" And then, and you're like, one, she's surprised. He was like, "What's your quirk?" Yeah, I mean, most of y'all niggas got a quirk. She's like, "If I consume someone's blood," crying still, sniffing, "if I consume someone's blood, I could become them." Deku bites his hand. "Here, don't sexualize this guy." And then she like basically gets the blood off his hand. Anywho, she does that. And then, she does that, and then she, transforms into Deku ever so briefly. And he's like, "Huh. Kinda cool. You could be a real beast. Imagine if your quirk got really stronger or something, he was able to use people's quirks or something." And she's like, "Huh? Wait, you don't think my quirk's weird?" "Well, to be honest, I don't have a quirk." And then, before they could finish, some average bullies, really just kids, some average bullies come through and they're just like, "Ah, oh, see, birds of a feather flock together. Look, two freaks. Judging from how this kid looks, I think he's a quirkless, I don't know, quirkless something." They just presume he's quirkless. "That's the only reason this vampire would have a friend ever." And he's like, Deku turns around on looking like some Super Saiyan 2 Gohan, like, "Niggas, I'm gonna tell y'all this once. Shut up." "Them? Oh, look, he thinks he's bad and big. Get him, boys." So they all try to jump Deku. Deku said, "Man, let me show you this. Let me show you something real quick." He took one good stance. He said, "I made this move up. Leaf. Hurricane." Dropped all those niggas with basically one move. He's like, "Yeah." And then they all activate their quirks, which is insequential. They try to activate it, and then immediately as that happens, Deku knocks them out, and they just start crying, running away. And then she was like, wow, let's just say Deku didn't say nothing about his quirk or not having one. She's like, wait, what? I thought you said you didn't have a quirk. What? Yeah, I don't. But you just took down people that were older and bigger than you. It's like, he points to his like kid muscles. Man, you telling me these guns don't count as a quirk? He's really being funny, trying to cheer her up and stuff. And she starts laughing. And then Deku looks down at her. He's like, all right, bro. He extends his hand out. She gets back up, and she's like, what's your name? Deku's kind of like, what's your name? And she's like, my name is Toga. I don't know what her actual name is, but I think that's what her name is. And then Deku's like, all right, cool. Well, I was supposed to make a friend, so... In his head, this is going to be more trouble than it's worth. I can feel it. Do you want to be friends, Toga? Don't sexualize this, guys. But Toga starts to blush. Yes! Deku. Oh, no, she wouldn't really call him Deku. She would call him Midoriya. Or, man, maybe she'll, like, see his name or something. He'll spell it out in the sand or something. He's like, hey, I could call you Deku. And then he's like, ooh. But he's like, no, I would rather you not. But then she, like, says what Uraraka said in canon, right? She's just basically like, it can mean whatever the positive version of it was. And he was like, all right, fine. I had to make at least one friend. He's like, wait a minute. Hold up. Do you know even know how to fight? She's like, no, well, here, I'll make a deal with you. And Toga's like, huh? If you keep training and get really good at fighting and stuff, when we get a little bit older, I'll teach you everything I learned. And he's like flexing his like arms and stuff like he's got muscles. I'll show you everything I know. And Toga's like, for real? Yeah. And so we're not going to do too big of a time skip because I'm going to save a good chunk of Deku's actual training later. But meanwhile, the ramen guy or the ramen family, that's just what we're calling them. They're literally spying on this nigga like, I think he made a friend. Like, they're so obsessed with this nigga's life, and like not a creepy way, but just like, I hope this kid comes out good. That they have like an uncanny attachment to this kid now. He's been there for 3 years. He helps the shop. It's like they love this little nigga, right? So yeah, him and Toga, they hang out every so often whenever Toga comes, and Toga decides, you know, to actually, you know, Toga does like surprisingly well and hides her quirk or like not goes overboard with it. And her mom sees this and her mom starts giving her support. We're going to blend this with What If a little bit. We're going to make it to where if y'all have seen Celestials, What If Toga was in UA or Class 1A, something like that. Or UA, yeah, it was UA. I had to use their What If or the premise of it just to get some type of idea because I remember seeing the videos. So if you see any resemblance, that's probably why. But we're not really going to focus on Toga. So they do that and Deku continues his training like per usual. And then they hang out every so often. But then eventually Toga, you know, doesn't come to the park anymore. And he's like, huh, Toga did say she wanted to tell me something. We can say they're about 10, so they've been hanging out for a year. Toga did say she wanted to tell me something really important before she had to go off to, let's say she's just going moving, or like they're moving, or they like gotta go to a different area so they won't be in this area anymore or something like that. And he was like, huh, I really wonder what it was. Well, just go back to Monkey Bar, the ramen fams. They're like, Deku, are you on the monkey bars again? Use it like a normal kid. As he's doing crunches with no effort. What do you mean? This is my normal. He continues. I have no quirk. On top of trying to fight, trying to be better than All Might, with a quirk alone would be an issue. But with no quirk, I have no room for luxury. Literally, we could just say his dad in this story. Not his actual father, but just the family. If y'all want to give me, like, names for these people and characters, that'd be cool. But he literally picks up this kid and just like, no. You've worked out plenty. You're going home and you're getting some rest, Deku. Mad. Pouting. Okay. Deku, they basically sent Deku up to his room. He's like, no. And he's like, oh yeah, I'll help out here. He's like, no. Because I know you got a weighted vest under there. Deku crying internally, knowing this is true. And then he's like, take the weighted vest off and go to sleep. You need your rest. It's getting late. We'll handle the night shift. Deku, mad, furious. And so then what ended up happening, right, is he does that. And then he starts meditating. He's like, man, you can't tell me I can't do now. And then the dude, you just literally heal the ramen dad from down the hall. And stop meditating. Just go to sleep. Deku, damn it. Hears him go to sleep crying. Not really, but like just crying like. And then he goes to sleep. And that's where we are in this piece of. My Twitch is BossDK, I want to say BossDK23, but if you want to reach me at any other place or want to get more information or donate, the link is down below, Linktree. Catch y'all later.